Now, when he's growing up on the farm and going to school, what kind of chores did Dad and Uncle Ed have?
Oh, they did whatever necessary. Ron always hated farming.
Oh, he did?
Mm-hmm. And he had Jan's folks thinking we kicked him out. His dad had kicked him out.
Uh-huh.
I don't know what all kind of stories he hadn't told her. And I never found that out until after they were married a long time. I wouldn't say anything to your mother about it now, but you honor a little shit. I did tell her that. I said, well, if you kicked him out, why, we wouldn't have kicked him out. He could have done anything. I don't know what he did about the motorcycle. You heard it, didn't you?
I know little. I've heard things about it, but I don't know the motorcycle.
Well, we don't know either. Even today, I don't know. The only little shits, they found out there was a motorcycle for sale.
Uh-huh.
Of course, we had told them they couldn't have a motorcycle until they had the money to pay for their insurance, because uh-huh. we would not let them drive a motorcycle unless they could afford insurance, because we were not going to be responsible for that.
Right.
They had cars, but they could not have a motorcycle. Well, one Sunday morning, I went to Sunday school. For some reason, the boys, two boys didn't go with me that morning. They chickened out on me some way. And I hadn't even gotten to Sunday school, and Dale and Gail Smith said, say that I was their teacher, the young people. And they said, that sure is a beautiful motorcycle that Ron and Ed's got. I said, what? I said, they don't have a motorcycle. Oh, yes, they do. And I said, no, no, they don't. And, oh, yes, they do. And I said, well, why do you think they haven't? Said, well, I said, we've seen it. And I said, well, I haven't seen any motorcycle. And I said, they know they can't have one yet. And
How old were they then?
Well, Ed must have been old enough to have, 16, I uh-huh. suppose. But Ron wouldn't have been more than
12 or 13?
13.
Uh-huh.
And that was the first time. Anyway, I said, oh, I'll find out. And when I left church, I went up to, it was a woman had a store right up in a gas station, right up town there in Bryant, mm-hmm. across from, I want to say, people that you don't know and won't know. But anyway, they right there in the corner as you go up to Bryant, mm-hmm. where the post office was,
right.
and
mm-hmm.
all that. Not now the post office, but the post office then. It was mm-hmm. right up on the corner next to the hard road.
Mm-hmm.
And there was a gas station across the road there where Mary's tavern is now.
Mm-hmm.
Bernice Dugan, she had a store there and gas station. So I drove up there, and there sat this motorcycle, and Ed was sort of leaning over, you know.
Uh-huh.
And I drove up by him and stopped, and I said, what have you got there, Ed? And he said, well, I've got a motorcycle. And I said, well, you know you can't have it. And he said, well, we've got it. And I said, no, you're not going to have it long. He says, well, I'll go ask my dad. And I said, well, you'll have to go ask your dad. But I said, you don't have the motorcycle. So he drove to Canton. His dad was helping Ralph on a place in Canton.
Uh-huh.
I drove up there, and I let him go, and I said, you can come back and tell me what your dad says. So in just a few minutes, he drove to Canton and see his dad. His dad told him to get himself home and put that motorcycle up and not ever touch it. And his dad come home and says, where'd the boys get the motorcycle? And I said, I don't know, but they've got it, and they've got it hid over in the big barn that was over at the big house there.
Oh, they hid it over there?
Over in the hayloft.
Uh-huh.
And so I guess Alvy went over with them, and they got the motorcycle out, and wherever it was they bought it from, they took it back quick. And that was one experience.